Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for Eye in the Sky. This is one of those movies that Helen Mirren told her agent, clear her schedule because she is doing this film. And she explains why. We had a chance to sit down with the Oscar winner and the director of this film about the morality of drone warfare. By the way, Alan Rickman's last performance, and man, does he do a great job.
This is Colonel Powell. She's going to walk you through the capture of Aisha Al-Hadi, a.k.a. Susan Danford.
We have intelligence of a meeting between Danford and numbers 4 and 5 on our most wanted list.
Talk about a decision. I mean, I can't even imagine anything more stressful than this. When was the last time that you, Helen Mirren, had to make a tough decision?
Oh, my goodness. Well, I've never had to make it. This sort of decision. Sure. The moments when you choose what job to do next, because in my job, we're constantly unemployed, you know, so we're constantly having to look for the next work and decide, well, you know, should I do this or should I do that? And that's always a pretty tough decision. But interestingly, with this movie, I said to my agent, it was, when we first started it, a very small movie. It was one of those movies that you don't know whether it will ever be seen by anyone. But I said to my agent, of all the films that are out there hovering, that's the one I want to do. And I, you know, if anything conflicts, that's the one I choose. I felt it was a great war movie. I felt, as you said, this terrible decision that has to be made. It must be the kinds of decisions that people have to make in warfare all the time.
When I look at the decision that has to be made in this film, I don't know that I've ever had to make a hard decision. Yeah. One of the things I really liked about Guy's script was the fact that he presents this dilemma from multiple points of view. From the point of view of the military commander, Helen Mirren's character, from the point of view of a pilot, Aaron Paul's character who has to pull the trigger, from the point of view of people on the ground who don't even know that the strike is going to happen and what it might feel like to be someone on the ground when a Hellfire missile strikes.
Do we have that CD yet?
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
You know, it's interesting because your character holds on to these beads during the course of the day, and I was wondering, was that something that you added?
Yes, it was, very much so.
So what was that? What made you think to add that?
Often if people are having to concentrate here, you know, they need something to play with. Mm-hmm. I once worked with a director, a stage director who was directing, and all the time he was wrapping and unwrapping a piece of sellotape around his finger like this. So he would have sellotape on the ends of all of his fingers.
Oh, wow.
And that was his way of displacing the concentration, I guess. Yeah. And there's something kind of cool about the clack and the sound of worry beads and the way in which you use them.
It actually calmed me a little bit.
Yes.
It's a tense movie. If anyone can pull off a camouflage onesie.
Oh, don't. Not me.
Oh, come on.
No, Nicole Kidman could. Or
she'd
Cameron
look good
Diaz
in one. I'll give you that.
But I can't.
No, you look great.
You know, yes, your butt does look big in that. I tell you, I loved it. 5 minutes in makeup, hair and makeup and costume in the morning instead of an hour and 15 minutes. You know. Fabulous. I loved it.
The beetle and the hummingbird, I mean, I'm all into that. How accurate?
Very accurate.
Really?
Go on YouTube. You'll find the hummingbird on YouTube.
Little things just flying around, they can get that close and right there.
Well, it's getting to the point where, our beetle and our bird are our own versions of what's being designed, so we're not being sued for stealing anyone's design, right. But I think our bird, no due disrespect to the people who designed the hummingbird, is kind of a cooler look. But there, you will find the hummingbird. He has a sort of reddish beak and a thick and flies around and he's been developed. Changes. It's the future of warfare. So if you want to know something of the future, the movie will give you a sense of where we're going. It might unsettle you, but it's not fiction.
Dozens of lives are at stake if these men leave.
We need to put a Hellfire through that roof right now.
Are you a rule bender? Because at the end of the day, she needs to bend the rules just a little bit to kind of fit what she has always felt is the right decision.
Yes, yes.
Are you kind of that rule bender or are you by the book?
Question. I think of myself as a very by the book person, but maybe I'm not. I'm a sort of by the book person who occasionally throws a little stone into the pond, you know, causes a few ripples. Nothing ever very big.
Yeah. Ask for forgiveness later. That's what
I say. Yeah.
Ready.
Right now. 3.
Go.
2.
Wait.
1.
Hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Eye in the Sky. Gavin Hood, I think, did a pretty good job. This is a tense film, and you see it from all perspectives. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And, of course, we'll see you at the movies.